how do you get a job as a newly graduated engineer? Well, it all depends on what you did during your university time. If you are motivated to learn and work, I will guide you through this video how you easily can get a job after graduation. If you want to finish your degree and go straight into a job, you will need to have used your university time effectively to build up your CV. Of course, this means getting a good academic result, but also carrying out work experience and taking part in extra activities. You have to apply for a graduate job quicker than you think. And if you want to do a work placement, you'll be applying in your second year. During your first year at university, you should try to work out what you want your CV to look like by the time you start applying for a graduate job, and then go out and get the experiences to fill it up. Well, so how do you get the experience? You shouldn't just be looking at a big companies. By working for a small company, you will often have more opportunities and responsibility than at a larger one. There are so many small to medium-sized firms that can offer you just as much, if not more, than a large firm with defined graduate program. You'll be amazed at the diverse range of smaller engineering consultancies that are able to offer graduate positions. In my opinion, fresh graduates should worry about learning to work instead of thinking about money for at least 1 to 2 years. Don't worry, you will be in demand after a couple of years. You can achieve a very good position in industry if you are a good learner. Your hard work, dedication, and honesty will help you a lot. You should always apply for a job when you are in a positive state of mind. The way you apply is affected by your mood. You should work on showing your interest and passion, create your own projects, and contribute to open source projects. And very important thing is, just target jobs you have a passion for and ignore how much they pay you. Your passion will show in your application and interviews, and you will be more likely to be successful. If you cannot find work experience in engineering, try to find a role that enables you to develop and demonstrate your key skills, for example, leading teams, problem solving, negotiating, etc., which can eventually be transferred to engineering. Don't just focus on your course at the university. Make the most of it with societies and friends. It often feels like you don't have time, but it's worth it, and it will help your application process. While at university, get involved with as much as you possibly can. Join sports, teams, committees, and clubs. Be a leader. Volunteer for a good cause. Do something outside your comfort zone, for example, learning a language. If you can demonstrate your core skills that your degree probably doesn't give you, you'll be more employable. Ensure that you at least have 2 non-engineering areas to discuss in an interview. It can be hobbies and other work that will allow you to demonstrate a wide range of experience. If you really can't find a placement in engineering, do something unpaid, like charity work, in order to build up software skills in the meanwhile. Doing anything as working in a shop or traveling is much better on your CV than just waiting to find an engineering job. Many university courses include time for a year-long placements, and these can often lead directly to permanent jobs. They could even help you do better in your degree when you return to university the following year. Placements will help you to develop academic skills because you will better understand how the theory is applied. They also allow you to make decisions about your career path. For example, you might change your mind from wanting to be design engineer to operations. Of course, the problem is that employers often want you to have experience before they will even take you on for a placement. Start by asking firms if you can come in for just a day to see how things work. Then try to undertake a few week work experience or a summer internship. This will put you in a better position if you want to apply for a longer placement, which can be almost as competitive as a permanent job. And don't forget that practical skills don't just come from work experience. They could come from social clubs, sports, teams, part-time jobs, or anything where you have demonstrated that you can do more than just calculations. My advice is to aim high and don't be afraid to apply for the companies you really want to work for. And remember, don't let your degree subject stop you from going for a particular firm or job that specializes in a different discipline. Basic principles of engineering are widely applicable. You might pick mechanical engineering because it's broad, but remember, something else doesn't necessarily narrow your options. But it's also important to remember some of the most interesting and innovative engineering is going on in the small and medium-sized technology firms, most of which you have probably never heard of. If you just apply to the big companies such as British Petroleum and Shell, you will not only face a lot of competition, you will also be missing out on some amazing opportunities out there. Small firms tend to require more niche skills and experience, and so struggle to find the right graduates. Matching yourself to right employer can create fantastic opportunities. Smaller companies can offer an accelerated career path, so you will get more responsibility quicker. And also remember, it's not only traditional engineering companies who recruit engineers. For instance, you could work as lighting engineer in, for example, the entertainment industry. So, in short, get a degree from a decent university with good grades. Do a placement or trainee year during the degree. If an opportunity to do volunteer work comes up, then take it. It costs you a few Saturdays, but the experience you get is worth that. Do your best in the final year project. It will empower you and give you confidence. Have a long-term plan that includes measurable goals. Align this with your aspirations, but don't walk into interview saying you want to be a manager. Get the technical part right first. And most important, learn how to write a good CV and write an individual CV and covering letter for each application. Generic ones are usually spotted from miles away. I wish you the very best of luck.